Good morning, students. Let's see the information of the lecture first and then we'll continue. Class 9, subject English, and the book we are reading is Moments. The moment book we are reading here, Moments we call it, means this will discuss when it comes in the particular chapter. This will be discussed with you people why the name of the book is called like this. And the chapter we are reading, The Adventures of Toto. The Adventures of Toto means we are reading about a Toto who is a baby monkey, written by Ruskin Bond. And students, this is lecture number 2. I hope so that you must have taken the reading of the lecture number 1 text we had. In that you came to know that the author and his grandfather bought a baby monkey whose name was coded as Toto, and he was kept in the private zoo of grandfather's secretly from author's mother. And some of the troubles they got and some of the problems they got when it was kept in the secret, though the grandfather was a bit happy to see that this little creature has a mind, as he donned blazer of the author. And this grandfather thought that if the time had been given to the little monkey, he would have made a rope of he would have torn this blazer in thrashes and would have made the rope and escaped from the room through the window. So what we got at the end, the grandfather had to go to Saharanpur for taking the pension. So he decided to take Toto along with him. This was we read in the lecture number 1, students. That means we got much familiarized with the Toto. What sort of creature is that, animal is that, and what sort of attitude it has? We got this, students. Now what we need to understand, that the attitude of the grandfather is totally different towards this little creature. So let's students, let's just read the first lecture. You came to know what sort of things took place in between the lecture there, what sort of text we had a reading. All right, let's go ahead. Hope that everyone can view this. This varies as per the quality of your internet. If the quality of the internet is good, you'll be able to view it in a proper way. And if it disturbs you, might have a little bit disturbance. So you just need to be careful, students, right? You need to remain in the class with your identity, because the attendance will take in any time. If anyone is found without, will be removed from the class. So let's start from the third para. Unfortunately, right? Unfortunately, I could not accompany. Unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on that trip, but he told me about it afterwards. Students, the author is saying to us, discussing with us through this line, that unfortunately means like some sort of reason is there, like which couldn't be shared. The author is saying that he could not give company to his grandfather on that trip. Like grandfather was going to get pension from Saharanpur, so author couldn't give company to his grandfather. But what happened as grandfather came back from there, he, his grandfather, told everything what happened there to the author, like shared everything with the narrator, we can say. A big black canvas kit bag was provided for Toto. Author is telling us from the very beginning, students, as we need to understand, a big black canvas kit. Canvas, students, you can underline. Canvas means a strong, heavy, rough material used for making tents or like bags or some sort of things which are very like strong, right? That's canvas, a sort of cloth you can see. And kit bag it got was provided for Toto. Grandfather got this canvas kit bag for Toto actually. This with some straw at the bottom of this bag, which was made of canvas and quite strong bag. Some straw means like students, stem of wheat or other grain plants that have been cut or dried. That means like stem refers to sort of, what do we call that, the grain or wheats, like a down part of the grain or wheat, which is used to eat by the animals. So that was kept, that was kept, that straw at the bottom of the bag actually became his new abode. Abode means, students, underline the word abode. Abode means living place, where this became the living place for the Toto actually. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. And you see, when Toto was kept in the bag, right, some straws were used at the bottom basically. And the clothes of which was made this bag of canvas was quite strong. Then this bag, when the bag was closed, came. It was not able to go out from this bag. It didn't have a space to leave the bag and could go out of it. Right? Toto could not get his hands through the opening, and the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. And what we get here, students, that Toto even wasn't able to take out his hands through the bag by opening this. And the canvas, means like sort of that cloth, was quite strong. Like it was not possible for Toto to cut it with his like teeth. It was not possible because the canvas is quite strong. That's why it wasn't possible. And his efforts to get out only had the effect of making the ball roll about on the floor or occasionally jump onto the air. Only two things could take place there, students, like when the Toto was in the canvas bag, he could either roll means like from one place to another place by just rolling, or like he could jump in the air. That he could do, otherwise he wasn't able even to bite that canvas bag or to just come out by opening the chain. That was not possible. An exhibition that attracted a curious crowd of onlookers on the Dehradun railway station. When they saw this, like the bag is jumping and falling, like a sort of exhibition, it seemed like attracted a curious crowd. People were there. They became quite curious or anxious to just see what is in it. And onlookers means the people who were there, they were just looking at that canvas bag on the Dehradun railway station. This was at the Dehradun railway station basically. People were just looking at the canvas bag, what is in it basically, why was it jumping and rolling. This was just making the crowd curious, means anxious. They were anxious to see why it was taking place, how it was happening there. Though it looked like an exhibition sort of thing, like people were taking interest in it and they were just trying to know what was in it. This attracted the attention of the people. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur. Till Saharanpur, Toto was in the bag actually. But while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile means like children, a gate at the entrance to public building. Turnstile means like sort of, you must have gone to railway station. When people are standing in the line, and some sort of barricades are used or pipes are used to just make the line proper. So that is called turnstile. That particular thing is called turnstile, right, everyone? We just need to be a bit careful that how it is going on. Students, So students, what we got crowd, the people on the Dehradun railway station were just quite curious to see what was in the bag. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur, and till Saharanpur, Toto was in the bag. But while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile, I told you, sort of barricade where people just stand in a queue or line to take the tickets or to show it. And it can be used like gate or entrance of any building, public building, city, right? So grandfather was just producing his ticket, means taking out his ticket, right? Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag. And all of a sudden, what happened? Toto suddenly poked out his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. Student, you can understand what is this wide grin. Wide grin means like this. Toto has looked at the ticket collector, showed his teeth, and just produced a sort of sound like monkey produce as they see the people or anything. This means like this was the reaction of the Toto after just looking at the ticket collector. Gave the ticket collector a wide grin. The poor man was taken aback. Taken aback means to be shocked and surprised. And that little means poor man means sort of person basically. Was taken aback means to be shocked and surprised. The person was surprised to see what it was, but with great presence of mind, and much to grandfather's annoyance. Now you see, students, annoyance refers to anger someone like that. We call it like annoyance. Students, just hold. Let me just take the attendance. It's okay. Now see. What happened? The poor man was taken aback, but with great presence of mind, means he just controlled his mind and decided like he would. Students, then he just controlled his mind, and after this, he saw that. The person, basically the ticket collector, controlled his mind, and much to grandfather's annoyance means like to anger someone, like it made angry grandfather a bit. He said, the person said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You'll have to pay for it accordingly." The ticket collector said this to grandfather, and what he said basically that you have to pay, you'll have to pay for it. Means he was asking to pay money as it came in the train. The ticket collector said this, like announced it, like it was a dog. You'll have to pay for it. According means whatever fare is decided for a dog, that grandfather has to pay this. Just students, hold for a minute. There is a little problem. Understand? So what happened? The ticket collector just demanded a grandfather to pay for the monkey, basically. And the ticket collector announced him or got him as a dog, basically. Why this happened? Because a little monkey gave a wide grin to the ticket collector, and that made him a bit angry. And then the ticket collector announced him a dog and asked him to pay fare for that little monkey, right? In vain did grandfather take Toto out of the bag. In vain did he try to prove that a monkey didn't qualify as a dog or even as a quadruped. Now you see, in vain means in vain means like without being success or unsuccessful attempt. Like in vain means unsuccessful attempt was done by grandfather. Like grandfather took out the toto from the bag and showed this to the ticket collector that it is not a dog. It doesn't qualify the dog, like as dog or like even as a quadruped. Quadruped means like students, any creature with 4 feet. Though this grandfather just tried to prove that this was a little monkey, but what happened there that the ticket collector did not agree. Toto was classified as a dog by the ticket collector. Means it was just, you can see at the picture also in the book, basically there was a discussion between grandfather and Toto, and they were just talking. Grandfather was trying to convince the collector that it was not the dog, rather it was a monkey. But Toto was classified a dog by the ticket collector, and 3 rupees of the 3 rupees was the sum handed over as his fare. Ultimately, what happened, students? At the end, grandfather had to pay 3 rupees. Was the sum handed over as his fare. You can understand, students, like this time the fare is quite high, but at that time the 3 rupees or the toto was purchased in the 5, basically. Right, students? So what happened? It was much worth, like this 3 rupees, that money had much worth than usual or now. So what are we discussing here? Like grandfather had to pay 3 rupees to just the collector for the fare of the toto, and that was a bit different actually. That the ticket collector couldn't get convinced, or like he caught it like this was the dog. And there was a tussle also between ticket collector and the grandfather. Even though grandfather couldn't succeed in persuading the ticket collector whether it was a monkey or a dog. At the end, what happened, that the grandfather had to pay for that monkey 3 rupees actually, right? Then grandfather, just to get his own back, took from his pocket our pet tortoise. Now children, you see, this is the scenario basically, when grandfather is just talking to the ticket collector, and when ticket collector announced that monkey as a dog, then grandfather got a bit angry. He just took out his tortoise. Grandfather was having his tortoise in his pocket. He took out the tortoise from his pocket and said, "What must I pay for this? Since you charge for all animals." Then there what happened, the grandfather got a bit angry and he said this to the ticket collector, showing the tortoise, that since like when you are charging for the animals, this is also the animal. As he was showing tortoise to the ticket collector, and he asked the ticket collector, what would he ask, what would he take, what would he charge for this little or small animal, and said, "What must I pay, what should I pay?" Basically, the ticket collector looked closely at the tortoise, prodded. Now you see, students, what we get there, right? The ticket collector just prodded, means like by pushing with fingers anything to just take what is this. Then what we got there, students, the ticket collector just checked it. Prodded means checked it with the 4 fingers, gave grandfather a pleased and triumphant look, means like while just smiling at the grandfather. The ticket collector said that, and no charge, it is not a dog. The ticket collector, while smiling, said to the grandfather that it is not a dog. So there are no any sort of charges for this sort of creature. While just smiling, the ticket collector said to the grandfather. Now you see what sort of incident took place there with the narrator's grandfather. This was very interesting, like the grandfather's incident, like grandfather was trying to persuade or convince that ticket collector, but the ticket collector was not getting agree with the grandfather. The ticket collector was a sort of stubborn person. He just proved and didn't accept that little monkey, that little creature was dog. He just proved it. He just asked to the grandfather that this was dog. And at the end, what happened? This was the government machinery, children. The one or the common people cannot protest much. And then the grandfather had to pay for this. 3 sum of rupees was paid to the ticket collector. Now you see next what happens. When Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, he was given a comfortable home in the stable. Stable means a building in which horses are kept, right? That's what a sort of place where he was kept. When grandmother came to know about that grandfather had got a new family member, she accepted it happily. And this Toto, little creature, was given home in the stable where horses were living there, where he had for a companion the family donkey. Now you see what we are coming to know, that there was a family member of that Toto whose name was Donkey. That was Donkey, and the name of that donkey was Nana. On Toto's first night in the stable, grandfather paid him a visit to see. And you see what happened. This was the first night of Toto at the stable. Then grandfather went there to see whether Toto was comfortable or not. But we need to see that the grandfather was not comfortable, students, because he was just thinking that Toto might be, you know, disturbance, or Toto might be disturbed just staying with the horses, or like the donkey, right? Some other animals or like birds were also there. So grandfather was not that much comfortable just by thinking this, right? So what happened? Grandfather paid him a visit. Now grandfather went there at the stable to see if he was comfortable or not, right? To his surprise, he found Nana without apparent cause. Apparent means, a student, easy to see or understand. Means that was not much easy or like to understand what sort of cause was there. Pulling at her halter, he found Nana. Nana means the donkey. Without apparent means not easy actually or understand what it was cause. Pulling at her halter, you know, this honky was just pulling at her halter. Underline the word, students, halter. Halter means like a type of rope, and trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. Now you need to understand this, children, what it means, what this line means here, what this gives the meaning basically, that a donkey, that the name of the donkey was Nana, it was pulling at her halter. Halter means like it was just pulling its rope on which it was bound basically, and she was trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. Bundle of hay means, students, that is grass. Bundle of grass is called bundle of hay. Right, everyone? Bundle of hay is called bundle of grass. When she was eating the grass, instead of eating the grass, that donkey, Nana, it was just pulling its halter. Means it's like what do we call it? A sort of rope with the help of which which was bound, and that donkey was trying to pull it. It was trying to get rid from that. So what we got, children, like, it was just disturbing the donkey. Grandfather gave Nana a slap across her haunches. Haunches means at the back, on the bumps basically. Grandfather just slapped that across her haunches, and she jerked back. Jerked means to give a sort of a sudden jerk, means jhatka de dena, ek dam se. Dragging Toto with her, and she dragged means to pull doggo with her, that Toto with her. He had fastened on to her long ears with his sharp little teeth. He had fastened now on her, fastened means like quickly on her long ears, and that Toto jumped quickly on her long ears, means the donkey's long ears, with his sharp little teeth, and he started biting and cutting her long ears with his sharp little teeth. That means what we understand, that little creature, that monkey was just a sort of a very naughty creature, and it created a lot of trouble and problem with the companions which were like who were living with that Toto at the stable. Ultimately, there were many problems which were created. A few we have understood, students, like the companion Nana was not comfortable at the stable. As grandfather went to just see whether it was or not, and that disturbed him a lot. Right, students? So, students, that's it for today's lecture. The rest we'll read in tomorrow's lecture, and we'll try to complete the text, whichever is fair. So whatever we completed today, if any one of you wants to ask anything, can raise your hand, children. Otherwise, thank you very much for joining the class. Now, if any one of you wants to ask anything, just raise your hand.